We know that DNA is the genetic material. You know it from your reading of books and knowledge from the previous classes. I know because I also have studied from the books, and someone told me that it is the DNA deoxyribonucleic acid that is the main genetic material from because of which the information passes from one generation to another, and the entire biochemical processes are regulated by the information stored in it. This has all been passed from one person to another. But what about the first time DNA had to be looked in for, and the first person who had to see and seek where this information is coming from and who is the carrier of this information? So the search had started way back in 1869 when Friedrich Miescher termed the acidic content of nucleus as nuclein. Okay, he said that there is some acidic substance present in the nucleus, and that was termed as nuclein. Due to technical limitations, it was way back in 19th century, and because of the technical limitations, the structure of DNA deciphering took a long time. In around 1960s, like 100 years later, the structure of DNA could be coined out. But in the meantime, it had started the search and the quest for finding out what the genetic material is, and if that acidic material which was found in the nucleus, if it is the genetic material. Also, for your knowledge, I want you to pay attention towards the simultaneous development that was taking place in terms of genetics, hereditary material, that the entire thing is going to be concentrated on the chromosomes. It was by the study of Thomas Hunt Morgan, the Mendelian studies, the Struthermann studies, this point, and they pointed towards the chromosome, that it is the main site from where this hereditary mechanism is going on. And DNA is the genetic material. When I say the genetic material, that means whatever is governing the hereditary purpose. So the search for the genetic material was within the nucleus around the chromosomes, and that happened to be DNA. How? We are going to see a few experiments and understand what all must be going in the mind of those people who had finally coined this, that DNA is the genetic material. So the first experimental proof or experimental development that we have in our syllabus is about the transforming principle. All right, this development and this inclination towards DNA as the genetic material started in 1920s, okay, and there was a close competition between proteins and DNA, whether proteins or it is DNA which is the genetic material. So we're going to see how that confusion got over and how could we finally conclude that it is DNA which is the genetic material without any objections, and some unequivocal proof would come and that would prove that it is DNA which is genetic material. But before that, in 1928, Griffith was one of the scientists. Now, this Griffith's transforming principle experiment is an important experiment which talked about transformation. Now, what was observed is that the physical characteristics of a bacteria changed, and they changed because of the genetic material. This was observed that it was DNA which could change the physical characteristics of a particular given bacteria that was taken for conducting the experiment, and that whatever object or whatever molecule it was named as transforming principle. How this was carried out? It was carried out by using the bacterial colonies of Streptococcus pneumoniae. Streptococcus pneumoniae, or otherwise called as pneumococcus, is a bacteria. It has two types of colonies. One are smooth strained colonies and the other one are rough strained colonies. Now, due to the presence of polysaccharide, mucus polysaccharide coat on the smooth colonied bacteria, these are virulent and is called S strain colonies. They are virulent. That means they kill the host. They are pathogenic and they are responsible for death of host which is infected. Roughs do not have that mucus polysaccharide layer and they have rough colony and they are non-virulent and called R strain. Now, using these two colonies, Griffith conducted an experiment with mice. Okay, a small mice was taken and infected with both S and R colonies. Now, pay attention to the experiment. You see, he took a mice, okay, and infected it with S strain. The mice got killed. That means S strain was virulent, it killed the mice. Then what he did was, he took the mice and infected the mice with R strain. The mice lives. It did not die. Okay. Now, what he did after this was, this is okay, we get an idea that this is non-virulent, this is virulent, it killed the mice, it did not kill the mice. In another experiment, in the next stage of the experiment, he took the mice and he heat killed S strain. He heated the S colonies, S strain colonies at certain temperature, not beyond 50 though, and when the mice was infected with such colonies which were heat killed, the mice lives again. That means whatever was causing the death of mice has been controlled by heat killing. Now, next step was that he took this heat killed S strain and he took R strain. Living R strain and heat killed S. Heat killed S strain along with living R strain was given to the mice and now the mice was killed again. Okay. Now, what he proposed from the understanding and observation of this particular experiment was that there was a transforming principle. There was some molecule behind killing the mice in S strain. All right, S strain had some information carrying molecule which killed the mice. It had that information enough to kill the mice. Later on, this R strain is not having that particular molecule which is having that killer information. When the S strain was heat killed, that molecule which was carrying the killing information got inactive. So, over here, this whatever molecule it was, it got inactive. And the information did not pass and the mice lives. But when this heat killed S, in which the molecule which carried the information was inactive, was brought in contact with the living part, then it transformed the information in R strain. Whatever was there in R strain that did not have the information to kill, it simply passed on its information. It transformed what was present in R. This part is dead. This colony is dead. The smooth strain is dead because it has been heat killed. It's because the component is dead, the cells are dead, the information carrying particle becomes inactive. But when that information carrying particle comes in contact with something living, it again imparts the information and gets the mice killed. And whatever that particle is, he named it as transforming principle. Later on, by another set of experiments, it was proved that it is not anything else but DNA which is responsible for getting the mice killed. That means the virulent strain had that information inside DNA. The virulence of the strain lied inside the DNA. That means the information, the genetic information is being carried by DNA. So, this was what was proposed by Frederick Griffith in 1928, and this experiment is quite famous in genetic studies to find out whereabouts and know-how of DNA, that is the transforming principle experiment by Griffith. You have to remember what steps were carried. I hope it is clear that simply one thing is killing and other is not killing. When other has been disabled of its killing ability but brought in contact with one which could not kill it, then also it is able to kill, and that has been brought about by the transforming principle.